I said no comment and I meant it. Oh, Greta, sorry. I'm sorry, it's just that the press, they're calling me nonstop. They're driving me crazy. I haven't forgotten about Spike's surgery. I have been stressed, but I haven't completely lost my mind. Yes, you know what? You can tell Dr. Norton that Spike and I will definitely, we'll be there. Okay.
Mama.
Okay, now.
Mama.
You know what we need? We need nature. Yeah, we need.
Slater's blood was found on the
kangaroos and all sorts of.
While no one has reported finding Slater's body, police sources are saying the longer a person is missing, the less their chances of survival.
Greenlight. We set her up.
We're not gonna do anything. We already did what we had to do. If I had to, I'd do it again. Greenlight got exactly what she deserved.
Hey, Zach. Hey, Zach. Wake up. Zach, darling. Don't sleep. It's me, Kendall, your wife, right here beside you.
Kendall.
Talk to me, sweetheart.
Please don't leave me.
Well, I'm not gonna leave you. I'd never leave you. Nothing will ever come between us. No one will ever come between us. Mm-hmm. Not even Greenlee. Mm-hmm. Did you know she saved your life? She literally saved your life. So how come you're not grateful? Sweet boys, you're calm now because you know in your hearts your daddy is coming home. He always comes home.
Kendall.
I'm right here.
Cool.
Of course not. I'd never leave you. We're talking about Greenlee and the terrible things that we did to her. Doesn't it haunt you, all the lies we told about her?
I want to make you happy. That's what I want to do.
I mean, we hurt her for no good reason. Shouldn't we just do what's right and tell the truth?
I shouldn't talk about Greenlee anymore, okay?
She feels so sorry about what happened. What happened that night. She lost her mind that night for 15... 20 minutes, but she was doing the right thing. She was turning around and bringing Spike back to you. She would never purposely hurt Spike.
You're safe. You and our children.
Greenlee is no threat.
No one touches our family, no one.
Just snap out of it, Zach. Snap out of it!
I will kill whoever tries.
Zach, please wake up. Don't leave me here alone.
Do you remember the lobster?
The lobster? mobster. Yeah. How could I forget?
Beautiful starry night.
I remember everything. I miss Greenlee. Zach, I miss my best friend. I was such a monster to her.
I adore you, Owen.
She's suffered, Zach. She's suffering because of what she did to your son, to our son. She's probably going to suffer for the rest of her life. Thank God kids can sleep through anything. An apocalypse, an eternal meltdown.
The longer a person is missing, the less their chances of survival.
No. Your entire family lost in a terrible fire. My goodness, how did you even manage to go on?
Well, I realized that I hadn't lost everything, that there was something left, and that something was me. And the grief and the pain, that was harsh and real, will never completely go away. But standing in front of a canvas, I was able to let it go for a while.
Lauren's experience demonstrates that creativity can be an escape from despair.
It certainly has been for me.
Fine. Fine. You know what? I'll weave potholders. That's what I'll do. I will weave potholders. And that will help me forget about the man that I love, the family that I've lost. That's right. You know what I'll do? I'll get Spike to help me. That's right. Spike will do potholders together. And Ian, when Ian gets old enough, he can help us too. We'll have an entire potholder industry. That's right. And maybe if I'm really, truly creative, I'll forget that there ever was a Zach. Yeah.
Find paradise with a guilty conscience.
Guilty of what? Why?
Framing Greenlee. Destroying Greenlee.
Greenlee belongs where she is.
This is much better, Amanda. Thank you so much. You and Babe have been holding down the fort since Greenlee and I have been away. I mean, you've been doing 2 and 3 times the amount of your normal work.
It's no problem. And feel free to snap my head off anytime if it helps.
Well, it doesn't. Makes me feel worse, actually.
JR says he doesn't remember anything. So what he says, and I actually believe him.
Forgetting, huh? One of life's many escape routes. Like sleep. Something I'm not getting much either these days. I can't turn my mind off. I can't stop thinking about Zach. Where is he? Is he hurt? Is he in terrible pain? I mean, is somebody going to find him at the right time? Will anybody ever find him?
Don't go there, Kendall, okay? You cannot go there.
Well, how can I stop? You know, my mom today, I was watching her show, and she had this artist on New Beginnings. And the woman said that she lost her entire family, but she claims that painting helped her survive. Yeah. Day after day, painting after painting, she says that it kept her sane. Oh, God. Oh, I'm sorry. I I completely blanked on your mother. I knew that Janet painted. I did. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
No. You see what happens when you're obsessing? I'm so focused on my own life.
Not everyone at the asylum is as sick as my mother. Sometimes they get better and they go back to their lives. Sometimes with canvases or sculptures or poems. Who knows if they're any good? But I don't think it's the finished product that matters. It's the doing that helps somehow.
New Beginnings is usually about providing hope for our viewers. But today, I'm the one who needs some help. Two people very close to me are missing. The first is my son-in-law, Zach Slater. He's the devoted husband of my daughter, Kendall, and father to their two very precious little boys. We believe that he may have been hit by a car a few nights ago near the border of Pine Valley and Montpelier. So please, if you see him, contact New Beginnings immediately. He may be seriously hurt. The other person in my life who is missing is Greenlee Smythe, my former stepdaughter. She may be frightened and she may be very reluctant to be approached, but please try to impress upon her that her father is worried sick about her. Please urge her to come home or to call New Beginnings. Please contact New Beginnings. Contact New Beginnings. Please help me bring these two people home. Please call the number below.
Creative therapy. Do you really think that helps?
I have a sketchbook. I think it helps.
Well, yeah, actually, when Greenlee and I, we were putting together the whole spring lookbook, working on it, it did help me forget about other things.
You two did a really beautiful job.
Yeah. We did, didn't we?
Greenlee belongs where she is. It's not how I feel, Zach.
Leave it alone, Kendall.
It doesn't have to end this way.
Nothing else to be done.
We could tell the truth.
Too late.
Why is it too late, Zach?
Because we did what we did. There's no turning back. Not like what you wanted to do in court. I can't believe you wanted to confess.
What do I need?
I was going to admit to framing Greenlee.
Come on, Kendall, you remember standing up in court.
Why didn't I? Why didn't I tell the truth?
Greenlee.
Yes, Zach. It's me.
No buts.
Why? Why didn't Kendall tell the truth? Why didn't she confess and clear my name?
Because I wouldn't let her.
From Zach, and I was wondering if you did. Nothing? Well, I know you're working. I know you're trying as hard as you can. I know that. Have you leaned any harder on JR to see if he remembers anything? Okay, what about the hospital? Have you checked the hospital? Well, have you double-checked? I'm sorry. Sorry, Derek, it's just that this is my husband that we're talking about, okay? Yes, I'm trying not to worry, but... Okay, but he's got to be out there somewhere, all right? He didn't just... He's there, okay? I know he's out there. He didn't just disappear into thin air.
Tell me why Kendall didn't confess. If she was gonna clear my name, why didn't she?
Because I wouldn't let her.
You bastard! She wanted to do the right thing. She wanted to admit to framing me, and you wouldn't let her?
Never even considered it.
Don't you get it? Don't you see? If you wouldn't have interfered, we wouldn't be in this mess. We would never have ended up in this godforsaken hellhole in the first place.
I thought you were Kendall.
Yeah, you were delirious. I played along. Thought maybe I could get some truth out of you. Guess what? It worked. Zach, if you would have let Kendall confess like she wanted to, I would never have had to escape. I wouldn't be stuck here, trapped here with you. Wow. Kendall was gonna risk her future to take back what she did to me. She still cares about our friendship. Yeah, I did that. I sewed up your head, tried to save your sorry life. I'm such an idiot, I should have let you die. Hey! I'm talking to you!
Never noticed that before.
It's cobweb, Zach.
Look up there.
What is that?
I know. Daddy isn't home yet, and Mommy's acting a little weird. Mommy doesn't really know what she's doing right now, but we will get through this together. I promise.
Here's an idea. You know what? Why don't you come with me? That's right. You guys can watch, and you can cheer me on. We'll do this together. Okay. Yeah. This is called... It's called creative therapy. It's what you do to help you with your troubles and get your mind off of things. It helps you cope. Right, Mother? Right. All right. Where were we? Coffee. I need more coffee. Coffee would help. That's what I'm gonna do. Who is it?
Delivery.
What? Hi. I wasn't expecting anything. Who's it from?
Zach Slater.
Oh my God. Last week, before he disappeared. Made for you. You're as beautiful as the night sky. I see moonlight in your hair and stars in your eyes.
even when the sun is out. Love, Zach. You too, Zach. Please come home to us. Please.
Slow.
Looks like some kind of a ladder or something, doesn't it?
You think?
How long was I out?
Long enough for me to get the truth.
By pretending to be Kendall.
Well, it worked. You were convinced.
Must have been some kind of a fever, because I wouldn't think that in my right mind.
You know, when you told me that Kendall was going to confess, that wasn't your fever talk.
Excuse me. You want to get out of here or not? Let's see.
Watch out.
What good is this gonna do? Zach!
We'll get up there.
How? You expect me to sprout some wings?
No, I expect you to be quiet for 1 minute. I'm gonna build something.
Yeah. That's not gonna work. Remember? The elevator I tried to make out of spare parts?
Maybe I have better luck.
You're such a man. If we even get out of here, I doubt you'll ask directions
back to civilization. You. Please.
I already looked in there. There's no magic toolbox.
Well, there's a rope. I'm gonna tie it off.
And then what? You're gonna climb up? You can't even stand on your own 2 feet.
You got a better idea?
Yeah, I'll do it. I'm lighter. Get it ready. I'll climb.
You could have lined up yourself.
So it'll hurt a little. It's getting out of here, away from you. Bring on the pain. Come on, we don't have all day.
Yesterday he said my eyes were fading fast away. I said